In Investing 101 today, the average cost of retirement is around $700,000. Are you ready? Today, we are turning to money expert Gene Chatsky, an award-winning personal finance journalist, AARP ambassador, and you have your own podcast. Hello to you, Gene. Great to have you here.
My pleasure.
Well, Americans are living longer. Do most people have enough money to retire?
We know most people are not prepared to retire. In fact, some brand new research from the Alliance for Lifetime Income shows that only about 25% feel confident that they are heading into retirement knowing that they'll be comfortable.
Why are people falling short?
There are two sides to this equation, and we need to get comfortable with tackling both of them. We need to make sure we're saving enough for retirement, but we also need to have a strategy so that whatever we save can be structured to last as long as we do. And many of us are not focusing on that half of the equation.
What are some sources of income beyond pensions or just money invested in the stock market?
The most common is something called an annuity, and an annuity is an insurance product. It can be structured so that it provides you with what's essentially a retirement paycheck. And there are many, many different types of annuities. A lot of different companies sell annuities, but you can start figuring out if one will work for you and what kind might work for you at a website called retireyourrisk.org.
I'm glad that you mentioned homework, because there are a lot of people out there trying to get your money with some of these annuities.
With any financial product, it is important to do your homework. Absolutely. I am a big believer in homework, and that's why I like this website. It was put together by a not-for-profit organization, and it's not aimed at selling you something. It's aimed at teaching you about these sorts of products.
Thank you for helping us out today with Investing 101 today, Gene.
Sure, my pleasure. Thanks.
Check out businessfirstam.com to find out where to see our entire show. And don't forget to like, follow, and share Business First AM.